Hello guys, this is Roy69501, welcome to my channel. The comic book that I'm gonna be displaying today was published back in 1993, and it is X-Men number 28. Look at that cover. Nice, huh? So I'm going to put it here. Let me put this baby here. Excuse me. Okay. Well, you see, this video is going to be different stuff. And yes, it's all comic book related. And the thing is that I'm going to show you a stack of comics here. This one here. And these are the comic books that I'm going to be dropping, that I got into the chopping block. Some of them are like 50-50, and some of them I'm not gonna get it anymore because they got canceled, so what's the point? So the ones I'm gonna stop reading is Incredible Hulk got canceled, Stormwatch I dropped. I mean, it's just I dropped. I mean, the comic books that I'm dropping now, don't misunderstand me. The reason that I'm dropping it is because I lost interest of the story or character or the superhero teams. Just I lost interest. Not because they're bad or they're lousy or they're not worth it. No. So the one, well, this one got canceled. Voodoo got canceled. Green Arrow is gone. The story got, for me, not that good. Justice League International got canceled. Superman, I lost interest. Action Comic, I lost interest. Resurrection Man got canceled. Avengers Assemble, they got canceled. Red Hood and the Outlaw, well, it's on 50-50. We see what happens on the second arc. Red Lantern, although it starts slow, went up, so it's on 50-50. We see. Suicide Squad, 50-50. Firestorm, chopping block. Frankenstein and the Shade, chopping block. Legion Lost, fifty-fifty. We'll see. Legion of the Superheroes, I go on the way to finish the second arc, and then I'll see what's gonna happen with the Legion of Superheroes. The same thing as goes for Legion Lost. So we see, once I finish reading the second arc, then I will decide if I should keep it or not. Savage Hawkman, chopping block. So it started in September, October. Well, Since I dropped all these titles, some of them got canceled. So am I gonna start? Am I gonna get some new titles if I see some titles that they are interesting enough for me to buy it? Then I will get it. But by starting in August, September, my comic book purchases is gonna have a overhaul. So although the one that I haven't mentioned, I'm still gonna buy them. It's just I just show you the ones that are shopping one. Now Marvel or Marvel Now, I'm gonna wait. There's only one that is really interesting, that really got my attention, is the one is a Pacific comic book that is a team. It's like they took some members from the X-Men and the Avengers and they form a team. I forgot the name of it. I think it's Mutant Avengers or something like that. That looks interesting. And I'm not sure about the other titles that they're going to be relaunching, or whatever they want to call it now. So, in the Marvel-wise, I'm still going to be reading Daredevil. So we'll see about the new titles. And about DC Cinema, I'm going to get all the, well, not all of them, but all the Batman titles. I'm going to get all the zero issues from the Batman Family, Green Lantern, including Red Lanterns. I'm going to get Red Lantern Zero. Maybe once I read it, and I finish with this second arc. Also, the Phantom Strength, I'm gonna get it. There are a lot of the. I'm still gonna be reading Batman Inc., Earth 2, Dark Age. Let's see. Basically, I'm gonna get quite a few of the zero issues. That's in September. So, also, I'm looking forward to check, because Image Comics now are gonna put up on the market some new titles. And the thing about Image Comics, my thinking, at least my point of view, is that Image Comics have no continuity at all. They only have that on the maybe of the major title like Spawn, Savage Dragon, and Saga. But other than that, I mean, they have quite a few that I don't read. But the thing about Image Comics is basically it's all about miniseries or maxi series, 4 issues, 6 issues, 5, 10, 12. So in a way it's good, in a way it's bad. I mean, it's like everything in life. No matter, I mean, it's like I said, it's like everything in life. You got the good side and the bad side on everything. Every single thing have the good side and the bad side. So Image Comics, the good side is all miniseries. To certain point, is good. The bad part is that once, if you are reading a miniseries or a maxi series and you won't keep on reading it, once you get to the last issue, it's finished. And you're like, okay, I want to read more, or there is no more because it's a miniseries. So that's the only thing about, that's the only bad thing about Image Comics. And also, I want to show you a couple of, I found one of my boxes, some Valiant issues. I want to show it here. But let me organize it first. Okay, this one goes here, this one goes here, and here, okay. Okay. Back in the 90s, I used to buy Valiant comics. Not all of them, because back in the 90s, they were expensive. I mean, for the price of one Valiant comic, you can buy two comic books. You just have to add, what, 75 cents more? Or 50 cents more, you can get two comic books for the price of one. So they were quite expensive back then. So the comic books that I got, the few that I had, I got Exiled issue number 0. Look at the cover. Here's the front cover and the back cover. Let me open it up. Look at that. Nice, huh? I'm going to show you some pages on the inside. Let me see if I can make one here. So, look at that. Nice, huh? Let me see if I can find some other page here. This is nice. This is a nice page here. Okay. I got EXO issue number 14. Now, this is a great cover. Look at that cover. It's done by Joe Quesada. Look at that. Issue number 16. Issue number 17. Issue number 19. And I also got the first 5 issues, the first 5 issues of Bloodshot. Here's Bloodshot issue number 1. I'm going to show you some pages on the inside. Okay. Oh, even comes with a mini poster. Look at that. Okay. Here's issue number 2. Issue number 3. Number 4. And the last one that I have is issue number 5. I don't know if the first 5 issues is the first arc or what. But one thing I noticed is that on each, maybe at least on these 5 issues, you got like a different character would appear on Bloodshot. Here you got Exo, right here. Here we got, what's his name? So each issue has like a guest appearance of some different character of the Valiant universe. And also I got 1, 2, 3 issues of Solo, Man of the Atom. Here's issue number 20. The cover's been done by Joe Quesada also. I'm going to show you some pages on the inside. Here's issue number 21. And here's the last one that I have, and this is a nice cover. Issue number 22. Now this is a nice cover. Okay. And also I want to mention that since I'm gonna be making different on my comic book box videos, once I finish showing all my series that I have, so which I already start, I already uploaded 3 videos. I mean, they're easy to upload it because only that they are very small videos, and it takes about 45 minutes to upload. And it's about, I'm going to be showing some of the some of the crossovers that I have, and miniseries, because I have a lot of crossovers and a lot of miniseries. I got all of them. So I'm going to be making, I mean, part of showing just a specific title of my comic book box videos, I'm going to also be showing different kind of miniseries or crossovers. One of the major crossovers that I have. And besides that, I was going to say something else. Oh yeah. I'm about to start reading this annual. This is Batman annual number 19, and it was published back in 1995. I mean, all the annuals back in 1995, they all have the title of year one. And this one, look at that cover. Oops, I'm gonna show you some pages from the inside. So although I don't remember quite a lot what this is about, all I know that is the origin of the Scarecrow. Tells you the story of why, when, and how he becomes a Scarecrow. So I'm gonna start gonna once maybe I read this tonight, maybe. Yeah, for tomorrow. But and then I decide to start rereading JLA. I already read the first 25 issues. This is the last one that I read. This is a nice cover here. And the one that I'm reading now is issue 26. And this was published back in 1999. Now, this is an awesome cover here. So, once I finish reading those, then I'm going to start reading these 5-part art, Crisis Time 5. So from issue 28 to issue number 32. Now this is awesome cover. Look at that. I know they are old comic books, but hey, it's nice to, well, I don't know about you guys, but for me, I kind of really enjoying I really have fun, or having fun, creating those vintage comic books, those old comic books. It's kind of neat. And also, I was going to add something else. What was it? I was going to add something else, and then just pop out of my mind. I guess when I remember what it was, I guess I have to make another video. Well, guys, this is it. Ooh, I want to say thank you to all the people that watch my videos, and quite a few new people that have subscribed to my channel. I want to say welcome. And I'm going to keep on doing videos. Yeah. I mean, I'm not doing it, just, I'm not doing the videos trying to be famous. I'm doing the videos because this is the only way, well, not the only way, but one of the way that I can show off my comic book. You know, it's nice, you know, to be able to make a video and show your comic book collection to the world. And let the world know what you think, how you feel, and about a specific story or superhero or whatever, you know. Well, this is it, guys. I hope that you like the video. See you next time. Bye.